إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. Indeed, the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah. وَخَيْرُ الْهَدِي هَدِي مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ. And the best guidance is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وَشَرُّ الْأُمُورِ مُحْدَثَاتُهَا. And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وَكُلَّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ. And everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is an innovation. وَكُلَّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ. And every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وَكُلَّ ضَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ. Every going astray and every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثُمَّ أَمَّا بَعْدٍ. My dear brothers in Islam, sometimes we ask when we find ourselves facing trial after trial, test after test, problem after problem, we find ourselves doubting what Allah has planned for us, but you must reassure yourself with Allah's words and with that of His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah states, مَا أَصَابَ مِن مُصِيبَةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ إِلَّا فِي كِتَابٍ مِّن قَبْلٍ أَن نَبْرَأَهَا إِنَّ ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ يَسِيرٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He states in the Quran what means no calamity, nothing you're going through, nothing that you will face befalls you on the face of the earth or in yourselves, but it's inscribed in the book of decrees, Allah al-Mahfud, before we bring it into existence. Verily, that is easy for Allah. ثُمَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ إِنَّ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقْنَاهُ بِقَدْرٍ. Verily, Allah said, verily, we have created all things with qadr, with divine preordainments of all things before the creation, as was written in Allah al-Mahfud. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ما يزال البلاء بالمؤمن والمؤمنة في نفسه وولده وماله حتى يلقى الله وما عليه خطيئة. This hadith that we find in the Sunan of at-Tirmidhi, and it is Hassan, it's an acceptable narration. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, trials will not cease to afflict the believing man or the believing woman. The tests, the hardships, the difficulties you go through in this dunya, they will not keep coming to the believing man and the believing woman in their self, in their children, in their wealth, until they meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without having any sin. So always find that comfort when you're struggling in this dunya, facing that hardship, facing those hard times, that this is a way for Allah to purify you of your sins so that you meet Him as if you hadn't sinned. وَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ حُفَّةِ الْجَنَّةِ بِالْمَكَارِحِ وَحُفَّةِ النَّارِ بِالشَّهَوَاتِ. This hadith, رواه مسلم, the Prophet ﷺ, he said, paradise is surrounded by hardships. It's not surrounded by the desires and the lusts, meaning you have to face hardship in order to make it to Jannah. And Jahannam, the hellfire, it is surrounded by temptations. Those evil things that when you go towards them, you are leading yourself towards the path of Jahannam. You're not going to get to Jannah, my brothers and sisters, my brothers in Islam, without earning it. You're not going to get there without tests, without trial, without difficulty, so Allah can test your true faith. Just like a person doesn't become a doctor or an engineer without going through years of schooling and tests. Just like somebody doesn't acquire a big home without working hard to earn the money for that home and then put it forth. Everything has to be earned, and Jannah is one of those things, but Allah has still made it easy for us. عن أنس رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن عظم الجزاء مع عظم البلاء وإن الله عز وجل إذا أحب قوما ابتلاهم فمن رضي فله الرضا ومن سخط فله السخط. رواه الترمذي وابن ماجه. And this hadith, Sheikh Al-Albani, he hasanaha, he said it is authentic. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, the magnitude of a person of the reward goes along with the magnitude of the affliction. The greater the trial in your life, the greater the difficulty, the greater the hardships, the more reward Allah will give you subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is when Allah, who is glorious and generous, when He loves the people, He afflicts them. This is only the view that the Muslim will have. That when I'm going through hardship, this is a sign of love from our Creator to keep us well-founded, grounded, humble, and having humility before our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah loves the people, He tests them and He tries them. And those who accept it, they will receive Allah's pleasure. And those who are displeased with what Allah has decreed for them, then Allah will be displeased with them. Again, this hadith is Hasan in the Sunnah of Ibn Majah and At-Tirmidhi. وعن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الدنيا سجن المؤمن وجنة الكافر. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said in the authentic hadith in the Sahih of Muslim, this dunya is a prison for the believer. It's not supposed to be easy. It's not supposed to be fun all the way. It's not supposed to be one of excitement and following one's desires and getting everything you yearn for and you want. It's not meant to be your Jannah. Ya ibadallah. O servants of Allah, this dunya is not our Jannah. So don't go after the things that make it a Jannah for you, because you will sacrifice your Jannah for the next life. This dunya is a prison for the believers. Anything great that you're going for, the biggest home, is nothing compared to a home which is a pearl, and you live inside that pearl, where birds fly and you can call for them and you'll have the best food at your disposal. Where fountains you will have of honey and milk and water and wine which does not intoxicate, that will be so quenching to your thirst by even a droplet of them. This is what Jannah has in store. So none of the good of this life can even compare to what Jannah is. That's why it's our prison. And Jahannam, Afwan, and this dunya is a Jannah. It is the paradise for the disbeliever. This is where they will enjoy whatever they want to enjoy of Allah's creation. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من يرد الله به خير يصب منه. Allah's Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said in the authentic hadith authenticated by Sheikh Al-Albani rahimahullah in Sahih Al-Bukhari, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, anyone who for whom Allah intends good, He makes him suffer some affliction. So when Allah wants good for a person, when Allah wants that person to be of His beloved ones, ones whom He is pleased with, He afflicts them and tries them so that they will meet Him with less sin, if not any sin. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is from the rahmah and the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. An Anis ibn Malik, قال كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا كربه أمر قال يا حي يا قيوم برحمتك أستغيث. وبإسناده قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ألذ بياذ الجلال والإكرام. رواه الترمذي وهذا حديث حسن. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, Anas, he said, whenever anything would distress him or trouble him, he would say, يا حي يا قيوم, O living, O self-sustaining sustainer, برحمتك أستغيث, in your mercy do I seek relief. And he would add that the Prophet ﷺ said, be constant with saying, Ya Dhul Jalali wal Ikram, O possessor of majesty and honor. In another narration, from the authentic things to say the adhkar of the sabah wal masa, of the morning and the evening, to say one time in the morning and one time in the evening, Ya Hayyu Ya Qayyum, bi rahmatika astaghith, aslih li sha'ni kullah, wa la takilni ila nafsi tarfat ayn. A beautiful dua, my brothers, for you to learn and to teach your families. O ever living one, O eternal one, by your mercy I call on you to set aright all of my affairs. Do not place me in charge of my soul, even for the blink of an eye. You don't care for the free will. You don't want to make your choices. You want Allah to choose to lead you on that straight path. This is why we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to control all of our affairs, even for the blink of an eye, even if it means hardship, because Allah knows better than we do. أَقُولُ قَالَ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهُ لِي وَلَكُمْ إِذَا اللَّهَ يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهدي ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وبعد. We have a narration in Sahih Muslim where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, عَجِبًا لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ إِنْ أَمَرَهُ كُلُّهُ خَيْرٌ وَلَيْسَ ذَلِكَ لِأَحَدٍ إِلَّا الْمُؤْمِنِ إِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ سَرَّاءٌ شَكَرَ فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ ضَرَّاءٌ صَبَرَ فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, amazing is the ways of the believer. Amazing is it. And for there is good in every affair of his or hers. And this is not in the case of anyone except a true believer. If some good comes to them, they don't pat themselves on the back. They don't puff themselves up in pride. They don't think that they earned it. They thank Allah because they know it came by his permission. And if some hardship afflicts them, some tests, some trials, they are patient, and that is what is better for them. So let us ask Allah to give us patience in all of the affairs He decrees for us, because Allah knows more than we do. My dear brothers in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلْ لَنْ يُصِيبُنَا إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَنَا هُوَ مَوْلَانَا وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, what means, say, nothing shall ever happen to us except what Allah has ordained for us. Allah is our Mawla, our Lord and supporter and protector, and in Allah, let the believers put their trust. We have to trust in Allah. We have to know that every hardship we go through, Allah has a higher wisdom and a higher knowledge of why He is putting us through that. And granted, for the believer, it's in their benefit if they are patient through that affair. ثُمَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ وَإِنْ تَوَلُّوا فَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ مَوْلَاكُمْ نِعْمَ الْمَوْلَى وَنِعْمَ النَّصِيرُ. عَفْوًا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, what means, and if they turn away, then know that Allah is your Mawla, Allah is your patron, your Lord, your protector, your supporter and sustainer. What an excellent Mawla, and what an excellent helper. So ibadallah, my dear brothers in Islam, never ask why or doubt Allah's wisdom. Never question why me or why is Allah doing this to me. But just trust in Allah, because He's the best of supporters, the best of protectors, the best of creators, the best of planners, the best of helpers, the best of commanders, the best of organizers, the best to decree every matter that occurs in the heavens and the earth. وَلَا يَظْلِمُ رَبُّكَ أَحَدًا. And Allah would never wrong any of His servants. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك أنت سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات اللهم إنا نسألك الرضا بعد القضاء اللهم إنا نسألك الرضا بعد القضاء اللهم إنا نسألك الرضا بعد القضاء سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.